A three-judge panel with the federal court says it is not intervening right now with the legislative map drawing process. A group of voters originally brought this case forward, calling to impose the third set of maps for the May primary. The judges set April 20th as the last day to get a map accepted and/or move the primary date.
I'm satisfied that they're not intervening at this time, which will allow the state government to continue to work to try to resolve this issue.
In new filings with the Ohio Supreme Court, some are calling for the contempt hearing to be brought up again because the commission revised the plan and did not create a map from scratch.
At that hearing today, an attorney for Secretary of State Frank LaRose told the federal court LaRose prefers to shift the primary to a single election day on May 24th. LaRose is one of five Republicans on the seven-member redistricting commission. I talked to him today about their 11th-hour refusal to accept the maps proposed by the paid independent map makers. He says they came in too late for review.
It would have been irresponsible for us to do that. Now, if the court had given us 2 weeks or 3 weeks, then perhaps that process could have played out.
But you had months to get this right. You knew what voters wanted. It was all done behind closed doors, and it was all partisan, right?
Well, what happened was that in some cases, both parties had been unwilling to negotiate. That was one of my frustrations.
LaRose insists as far back as September, he was hoping the two sides would work together. But Democrats on the commission insist they were cut out of the process as the GOP majority passed three separate unfairly imbalanced maps.
What does this say to voters, though, that this process went on for so long, it has cost so much money and taken so much time, and still the commission didn't get it right?
Well, I would argue that the commission did get it right. We have a provision in the Constitution that says that if you can't reach bipartisan agreement, which was my first goal, that there is a backup plan, and that is that the commission can pass a four-year map.
LaRose says the Constitution allows the GOP majority to create a four-year map that favors and protects Republicans. He says what's improper is the Supreme Court ordering the commission to create 45 Democrat-leaning districts.
It's pretty unfortunate that we're, you know, drawing these districts that start in the cities and reach way out into the suburbs just in order to get this
arbitrary
number.
But that's how the districts are right now. I mean, that's why they're called gerrymandered. They're salamandered through the state.
That's why we reformed the process.
LaRose says he believes Democrats have a national strategy of filing activist lawsuits with sympathetic courts, calling it sue until you're blue.
So at the end of this process, as we sit here right now, what grade would you give the commission on this process?
You know what? A C. Passing, but not exemplary. Unfortunately, there are partisans on both sides that have kind of dug in and said, you know what, we have the majority, so we can do what we want. And on the other side, they said, well, hey, we think we've got the sympathy of the court, so we can do what we want. Unfortunately, when people aren't at the table actually compromising and trying to come together, it becomes impossible to find that middle ground.
Already, the League of Women Voters and other voter advocacy groups are asking the Supreme Court to reject the map that Republicans passed on Monday.
An important reminder from your local election headquarters: if you have not registered to vote in the May primary, Monday, April 4th is the deadline. You can check your registration status or register online. We have a step-by-step guide on how to do so at NBC4i.com.